Homeland Security just announced that any travelers from West Africa, from Liberia, from Guinea, from Sierra Leone, will have to go through the 5 airports you had designated last week with the enhanced screening measures. And as you I believe said last week, that covered virtually everybody that was coming in from those countries, but not entirely. Why was not this policy that's being announced today put in place back then, since it would have been presumably 100% coverage?
Well, Jim, what we have said for some time is that the president stands ready to consider additional travel restrictions as necessary to further protect the American public. And this is an example of an additional travel restriction that could be put in place by our Homeland Security officials to ensure the safety and security of the American public. So, you know, when the president was asked in the Oval Office on Thursday evening of last week about a travel ban, the president explained why he did not believe that a travel ban would be in the best interest of American public safety, but he did indicate an openness to additional travel restrictions that could be put in place to protect the American public. This is an example of one of those travel restrictions, and it's something that, this is relatively creative policymaking. This is a situation where the Department of Homeland Security had to work with airlines that are flying passengers from a variety of countries from Europe to the United States. It did require some work with the State Department to inform other countries. So there's a lot of coordination that had to go into developing and implementing this policy, and we're pleased to see that it's being implemented starting tomorrow, I believe.